Good morning, everyone. We are back with the fourth session of similar triangles for class 10. We'll be doing exercise 6.3 now. Just see question number one. State which pairs of triangles in figure 6.34 are similar. Write the similarity criterion used by you for answering the question and also write the pairs of similar triangles in the symbolic form. Have a look at figure 6.34. I want to prove triangle ABC similar to triangle PQR. Now, what do I do that? I will observe that three sides are given for this and three sides are given for this. Let me check the ratio of the sides. I have where I have 2, AB is 2, I have QR is 4. If I have BC is 2.5, I have RP equal to 5 centimeters. If I have CA equal to 3, I have QP equal to 6. Therefore, the ratio of AB to QR is 1:2. Ratio of BC to RQ is 1:2. Ratio of CA to PQ is how much again? 1:2. Now let us understand how we will name the triangle. So I know that this triangle is similar to this one. That means triangle ABC, when I say, means I am going from the side 2 to side 2.5. The same way I'll have to go this side also. Double of 2 is 4, double of 2.5 is 5. So I'll go from the side 4 centimeters to the side 5 centimeters. So I'll get triangle ABC is similar to triangle QRP. And since the three sides are proportional, so just by the SSS criterion. Let us see the second part of this question. I need to prove once again this triangle similar to this one. Let us check whether this is going to be similar or not. Two sides and one angle of this triangle are given, and two sides of one and one angle of the other triangle are given to me. For similarity, the criterion that we had done was SAS rule, which said that if two sides are proportional and the angle between them is equal, then in that case, triangles are going to be similar to each other. So let us check here. Here I have the side 2.5, double of that I have 5 here. The side is 3, the double of that I have here 6. That means the side SS rule is being fulfilled. Let us see whether the angle, what about the angle? This angle A is not the included angle, whereas SAS says that the angle is the included angle. That means had angle B been equal to angle F, then the triangles would have been similar. But here it is not true. Since B is not equal to angle F, therefore the triangles are not similar. Let us take up now the second question and the third question. They are simple enough. It is given to me that triangle ODC is similar to triangle OBA. That means angle D should be equal to angle B. If this is 70, then automatically this also comes out to be 70. And then this is again how much? By the linear pair, I know that this is 55. So by the angle sum property, this also comes out to be 55. The third question, diagonals AC and BD intersect at point O. All right, I need to prove the thing that OA upon OC is equal to OB upon OD. Okay, now if you see here, OAC is what it is, one straight line. So I will not take this. I will try to take it horizontally. If I see OAB, is it forming a triangle? So yes, OAB is forming a triangle. So I'll take one triangle AOB. Second triangle, I'll take OCD triangle. Are they going to be similar, OAB and OCD? Let us check. This angle is equal to this one by the vertically opposite angles. Angle BAO, if you see, this is trapezium given. So AB is parallel to DC. So angle BAO will be equal to angle OCD by the alternate interior angles. Two triangles are similar by AA rule of similarity, and I will get that OA upon OB will be, rather OA upon OC will be equal to OB upon OD. Hence it is proved. In the figure 6.36, QR upon QS, that means that I have QR upon QS is equal to QT upon PR. Okay, PR. And angle 1 is equal to angle 2. If angle 1 is equal to angle 2, can we use the isosceles triangle property? The isosceles triangle property says that PQ will be equal to PR by angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So I can use that, show that triangle PQS is similar to triangle TQR. PQS is similar to triangle TQR. Two sides of this triangle, if they are proportional to two sides of the other triangle and the included angle is equal, then the triangles would be similar. So how do I do that? Because angle 1 is equal to angle 2, instead of PR, can I write PQ? Yes, I can write that by the similar, by the isosceles triangle property. Therefore, what do I get now? QR upon QS is equal to QT upon QP. And angle 1 is the common angle. Therefore, the two triangles similar by the SCS rule of similarity. It's been done here for you. You can see the proof yourself. Question number 5 again can be done. See the figure here. The figure is given to you. If you see, angle P is given equal to angle RTS. Angle R is the common angle. So I have two angles of this triangle. Angle R is equal to angle R. Angle T is equal to angle P. Therefore, I get RPQ triangle similar to triangle RTS. By which rule will it be? By the AA rule of similarity. Now see what is given to us. In the figure 6.37, that means this figure, triangle ABE, ABE is congruent to triangle ACD, that means this triangle. Show that triangle ADE, this smaller triangle on the top, ADE, is similar to triangle ABC. Now clearly you can see one angle A is already common. I can prove this side upon this side is equal to AE upon AC, and angle A being common, again by SCS root also triangles could have been similar. So let us see how it has been done. Now because AB is congruent to ACD, naturally I can say that AB side is equal to AC side. So AB upon AC comes out to be equal to 1. Exactly same way here, because this triangle ABE is similar to triangle ACD, naturally AD side would be equal to AE side. Hence, AD upon AE will also come out to be equal to 1. That means I can say that AD upon, if I just interchange this, if I interchange this, I get AE upon AC will be equal to AD upon AB, and angle A is a common angle. Therefore, by the SCS rule of similarity, triangles become similar. AD and CE are the altitudes of triangle ABC intersecting at point P. I need to prove these triangles similar. By using one common angle and one angle 90 degrees, all of them can almost be done easily. Eighth question, if you see, is the point on the side AD produced of a parallelogram ABCD? So draw a parallelogram, produce the side AD to E, then from B, join BE. BE intersects CD at F. You can easily show that triangle ABE will be similar to triangle CFB by one, vertically opposite angles, and second by the alternate interior angles. Ninth question. Again, the figure has been given to you. I need to prove triangle ABC similar to triangle AMP. Very simple, I can do. Angle A is common. This is 90, this is 90. The triangles become similar by the AA rule of similarity. Once the triangle is similar, by CPSC, what do I get? AB upon AM will be equal to CA upon PA will be equal to BC upon MP. And last two, if I take, I'll get CA upon PA is equal to BC upon MP. And that is what I wanted to prove. See the 10th question. CD and GH are respectively the bisectors of angle ACB and EGH. See here, this angle C is bisected by CD. So angle 1 becomes equal to angle 2. Here, angle G is bisected by GH. So angle 3 is equal to angle 4. It is given to us, if triangle ABC is similar to triangle FEG, that means it's already given to us that ABC is similar to triangle FEG, I need to prove certain results. Now, because ABC is similar to FEG, what all will I get? I'll get angle A will be equal to angle F, angle B will be equal to angle E, angle C will be equal to angle G. Also, AB upon FE will be equal to BC upon EG will be equal to AC upon FG. Now, what do I get here? I need to prove what? First of all, CD upon GH is equal to AC upon FG. Now, see which triangle should I take? If I take this, CDH is forming no triangle. CAD, is it forming one triangle? So, I'll take the CAD triangle and similarly, I'll take this FGHF triangle and I'll prove them similar. How do I do that? Clearly, angle A is equal to angle F because the triangle is similar. This complete angle C was equal to complete angle G. Naturally, their halves will also become equal. So, I get angle 2 equal to angle 4. A was already equal to F. Hence, these two triangles are similar. Therefore, sides are going to be proportional by the CPST. And I'll get CD upon GH will be equal to AC upon FG. And that is what I wanted to prove. Now, what I want to prove next, triangle DCB similar to triangle HGE. That means triangle DCB similar to triangle HGE. I think it can be done the same way. See, this angle B is equal to angle E because the two triangles ABC and FEG were similar to each other. Also, this complete was equal to this complete angle G. So, their halves are also equal. So, angle 1 will be equal to angle 3. And hence, the triangles will be similar by AA rule of similarity. The second part is also done. See, the third one now, triangle DCEA is similar to triangle HGF. To prove this result, we have already done this part. So, I think all the three parts are done. Now, see the 11th question now. In the 11th question, though it is a homework question, this question you should be able to do on your own. I'll just explain it. I have AD perpendicular to BC, EF perpendicular to AC. I need to prove that triangle ABD is similar to triangle ECF. ABC is an isosceles triangle. So that means angle B will be equal to angle C. And also this angle D here, ADB is equal to angle EFC 90 degrees. Hence the two triangles will become similar by the AA rule of similarity. Begin with the 12th question now. The sides AB and BC and the median AD of triangle ABC. Now, what is the median? Median is the line from one vertex of a triangle to its opposite side to the midpoint of the opposite side. That means if I say AD is the median, means that it is given to me that D is the midpoint of BC and hence BD is equal to CD. Also, same way, if PM is the median, then that will mean that M is the midpoint of QR, that means QM will be equal to MR. So what is given to us? The sides AB and BC and the median AD of triangle ABC are respectively proportional to the sides PQ, QR and the median PN. Show that triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Now it's quite simple to prove this. What do I do? It is given to me that AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AD upon PM. Instead of BC upon QR, can I write twice of BD upon twice of QM? Because I just now told you, because AD is the median, BD will be equal to DC. So instead of BC, I can very comfortably write twice of BD. Instead of QR, I can write twice of QM. So this relation AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AD upon PM can be written as AB upon PQ is equal to twice of BD upon twice of QM, which is equal to AD upon PM. Now that means 2 and 2 cancel. So I'll get AB upon PQ is equal to BD upon QM is equal to AD upon PM. Does that not mean that this triangle ABD is similar to triangle PQM? By which rule? by SSS rule of similarity. And hence, angle B will be equal to angle Q by CPST. Now, again, take a look at the bigger triangle. I had already given to me AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR. And now I have proved angle B equal to angle Q. So triangle ABC will be similar to triangle PQR by the SAS rule of similarity. Let us see how it is being done. See, what was given to us was written. What is to be proved is written. I need to prove what? I need to prove that this triangle, bigger one, is similar to this bigger triangle PQR. So I prove, first of all, this triangle, you can see ABD, similar to triangle PQM by the SSS criterion. Therefore, that gave me angle ABD is equal to angle PQM, which again gave me, I now proved after that, this by SAS rule, I proved the two triangles similar. So I think it's going to be clear to you. 13th is a simple question. You'll be able to do it. See the 14th question now. It's a little different from the previous one. The 12th question said that one side, the median, and the side on which the median is falling are proportional to one side, median, and the side on which the median is falling. These, they are proportional to each other. But now it is the two sides containing the median and the median are proportional respectively to two sides and the median. Just read the question. Sides AB and AC and median AD of triangle ABC, AB, AC and median AD are respectively proportional to the sides PQ, PR and PM of another triangle PQR. Show that the triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Little lengthy question. Understand how it is to be done. I'll make a construction. I'll produce this AD to point E such that AD is equal to DE. Exactly same way. I'll produce this PM to point N such that PM becomes equal to MN. Then I'll join EC and I'll join NR. Now, take these two triangles. If you see these two triangles, is AE twice of AD or not? Exactly same way, because AD was equal to DE by construction. Exactly same way, PM is equal to MN. That means, can I say PN is twice of PN or not? So, I'll use these two things. Let us see how it is done. In triangle ABD and triangle CDE, ABD and triangle CDE, AD is equal to DE by construction, BD is equal to DC given to me because AD is a median and this angle is equal to this angle by the vertically opposite angle. So I get that triangle ADB is congruent to triangle EDC. By the SAS rule of congruence. So therefore, I will get AB is equal to CE. Exactly same way, if I take this triangle, I can prove PQ equal to RN. Okay, now I take what was given to me, AB upon PQ was equal to AD upon PM was equal to AC upon PR. This was what was given. Instead of AB, I write CE. Instead of PQ, I write RN. So I get AB upon PQ changes to CE upon RN. AC upon PR is equal to, I let it remain as it is, AC upon PR. AD upon PM, I can rewrite as twice of AD upon twice of PM, which will be equal to AE upon PN, and hence I'll get AC upon PR equal to AE upon PN is equal to CE upon RN. Therefore, triangle CAE will be similar to triangle RPN. Hence, angle 4 will be equal to angle 2 by CPST. Also, angle E will be equal to angle N by CPST. All right, but E was equal to what? E was equal to angle 1, angle n was equal to what? Angle 3. That means 1 is equal to 3, 2 is equal to 4. That means complete angle A, 1 plus 2 is equal to complete angle B, 3 plus 4. Now once again have a look at triangle ABC. I had AB upon PQ given equal to AC upon PR. And now I have proved angle A is equal to angle P. Hence by SAS I can say that the triangles are similar to each other. We can go through the proof once again. See the 15th question. A vertical pole of length 6 meters casts a shadow 4 meters long on the ground, and at the same time a tower casts a shadow 28 meters long from the height of the tower. See here, this pole AB is casting a shadow equal to 4 meters. Same time, this tower DF is casting a shadow 28 meters long. When I say the time is same, means the sun's elevation is same, and hence this angle C will be equal to angle E. This is 90 degree already given to me. Therefore, triangle ABC will be similar to triangle DFE by the AA rule of similarity. If the triangles are similar, then the sides will be proportional. That means 6 upon 4 will be equal to H upon 28, and I will get the required result, that the length of the shadow will be equal to what? It will be equal to 42 meters. 16th question. If AD and PM are the medians of triangle ABC and PQR respectively, where ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Now converse is given to us. It's given that the triangles are similar to each other, bigger triangles are similar. I need to prove AB upon PQ is equal to AD upon PM. We'll just go in the reverse order this time. Now, because these bigger two triangles were similar, angle B will be equal to angle Q, angle A will be equal to angle P, angle C will be equal to angle R. Also, AB upon PQ will be equal to BC upon QR, will be equal to AC upon PR. I'll be needing what? I'll need angle B equal to angle Q. That's my first equation. Also, AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR. Because AD is the median and PM is the median, so instead of BC, can I write twice of BD? Exactly same way, instead of QR, can I write twice of QM? So I get AB upon PQ is equal to BD upon QM. And angle B was equal to angle Q. Hence, the triangles are similar by the SAS rule of similarity. And I will get that AB upon PQ will be equal to AD upon PM. And that is what I wanted to prove. It's been done for you. You can just go through the proof yourself. I think it's going to be very clear to you. This finishes off with this session. If you have any problem, go through the video again. I'm sure you'll be able to follow it. Thank you so much.